Today, I will introduce you to the new data-oriented technology stack from Unity. For your convenience, I've added chapters and subtitles to this video. Let's get to it. For this first video, we will focus on setting up the project and giving a brief presentation of the package that Dots is composed of. First, open the Unity Hub to create a new project. In the project creation window, you have to select the 2021.3 LTS version. Any revision should do, but if you want to follow along this series, I highly recommend to use the same version as I do. Next, pick the project template. I will use the 3D URP template. Name the project and click Create. Once the project is open, go to the Package Manager. If you are not familiar with it, the Package Manager allows us to import additional feature modules into the project. Dots is still mostly under development by Unity, so most of the packages that compose Dots are not production ready, and we need to acknowledge that to be able to import them into the project. At the top right of the Package Manager window, click on the gear icon and open the Advanced Project Settings. Enable the pre-release package and acknowledge the warning about pre-release packages. You can also enable the Show Dependencies to see what packages rely on each other. Close the Advanced Setting window and go back to the Package Manager. The simplest way to import the Dots package is to import the hybrid renderer. Its dependencies will take care of importing the rest of the packages with coherent versions. In the top left of the window, click on Add Package by Name and type in com.unity.rendering.hybrid. The package name is in the description if you want to copy-paste it. Once importing is finished, you will notice you have a few more packages in your project. The hybrid renderer we just explicitly imported. That package handles the rendering of entities, which is why it depends on the entities package. The entities package contains all the building blocks for the entity component system framework we will explore in the next videos. And this package depends on other packages that are part of Dots. The burst compiler that optimizes your compiled code by choosing the best processor instruction for your architecture and understand your code to vectorize it when possible, or optimize branching code based on the likelihood of the condition. And finally, the job package that allows easy and safe multithreading and work in tandem with the collection package, which contains thread-safe unmanaged data containers such as arrays, lists, maps, streams, and others. There are two more packages that were not imported, the physics package and the netcode package, but we will get those when we need it later in the series. We already have plenty to cover with those packages. As said earlier, most of the data-oriented technology stack is still under active development. Therefore, most of the packages show an experimental tag. If your plan was to make a full featured game using Dots only, you might want to reconsider, as not all the features required by a game are supported yet. We don't have animation or audio, for instance. But don't worry, it does not mean that you cannot benefit from Dots either. So, if you want to get ahead of the herd and start learning the fundamental principles of Dots, stick with me, and I'll do my best to guide you on this journey. Now that we have Dots in our project, you should see a new Dots menu. We won't get into the option details yet. First, we will set up our workspace layout and start introducing the main ECS concepts. In the window menu under Dots, you will see four new windows. The archetype window. Archetypes are unique sets of components that any given entity matches. They are the template used to make entities and store data in tightly packed chunks of memory. The component window. Components are the individual pieces of information your game operates on. Simplest example of data can be the position or rotation of any object in your scene, or the health of a player. The component doesn't know or care about the object they are associated with. Else is else, whether it's for a player, a monster, or a destructible object. Next, the hierarchy window. As you probably guessed, it will contain a tree of entities. Entities are just identifiers. They don't contain any information and they don't define any behavior. All they are two integers, one called index and one called version. When an entity is created, it gets assigned an index and a version. When it gets destroyed, the index is reused with a different version number. That gives us 2 to the power 62 possible entities during our game lifecycle. And last, the systems window. Systems are where you will define your behaviors. They operate on components and define the behavior for those components. We can filter on which entity they operate through entity queries so that we can define different behavior for the same components. For instance, a plane will not behave as a car. For our workspace layout, the main windows we are interested in are the hierarchy window and the systems window. You can open the hierarchy window and dock it next to the hierarchy of the game objects. For the system windows, what I like to do is rearrange the console and project windows in this fashion. That's it for now, thanks for watching. If you like this content, hit the like button, share, comment, and don't forget to subscribe or you will miss the next video.